Thank you, Randy Newman. Song called Political Science, in case you were wondering. All right, let's try this again. I've got another hotel in Iran. I'm not going to give out the name in case this one actually goes through. It's got 250 Google reviews and a 3.8 rating. And hopefully it will ring. It's looking like it's trying to connect, in case you're wondering. Oh, my goodness. We are trying to call. Yes, that was Randy Newman. We are trying to call a hotel in Tehran because I would like to speak to an average person there. So far, it's looking like it's trying to connect and it's not going through. I see Chris Dirks in the YouTube chat room got me the number of another hotel. So if this doesn't go through, hello.
Oh, that was the family.
Hi, do you speak hello, do you speak English?
Hi.
Hi, do you speak English?
Yes, really.
You speak English?
Yes.
Hi, my name's Nicole.
Hi.
And I'm actually calling from America because it looks
like
I'm calling from the United States because I'm concerned.
Okay.
I'm concerned about what's going on between our two countries. Can I ask you, I don't want your name. I don't want you to identify yourself. I didn't say where I'm calling. I'm on the radio. I'm on an internet radio station here. Can you tell me if you guys are as freaked out as we are about what's going on right now, about the possibility of some kind of war?
Now 12 night. Tomorrow morning call, okay?
Tomorrow morning I should call. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, tomorrow morning 7 o'clock.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
All right. I guess he couldn't talk. All right. Well, I'm going to try this other one because that one worked. So we'll give it one more shot. You know, I've done this from time to time over the years. The first time I did it was during the Arab Spring, and I called hotels around Tahrir Square, and I had some of the best conversations with people who were just hoping that the world was going to all of a sudden get better. And sadly, that's not what happened. So now I'm calling this other hotel. They do speak English. And from what I understand... Hello, do you speak English?
Hello.
Hi, do you speak English?
Hello, how may I help you?
Yes, yeah. Hi. My name's Nicole. I'm calling from the United States. Can we talk? I'm calling just to say that I'm kind of upset, very upset about what's going on. And I wanted to speak with just an average person in Iran to tell you that we have no hard feelings towards you. Are you as freaked out as we are about what's going on between our two countries right now?
You know, it's something normal in Iran, Mom. There's nothing to worry about. If you want to see anything, if you want to read the news, the websites, the online websites, the newspapers, everything are okay. I can't. But about the hotel, if you have any question, I can answer.
No, I call a hotel because I figured people would speak English there. I just want to know if the average person in Iran.
No, if you want to speak directly to someone, it's okay, but. But you're speaking to someone that has no news, you know.
No news, but
you can open the website and ask about it. Hold on, please.
Okay. Well, he speaks good English, right? He just doesn't seem like he wants to talk to me very much.
Sorry, Mom. It's really crowded here.
Oh,
just
it is.
Open the website and read all the news.
Okay. I actually wanted to know just an average person.
Sorry,
what
I can't
you
give
think.
Any
you
information.
I got you.
Directly from the phone.
Okay.
Sorry, Mom, if you
all
have
right.
any question about the hotel, about the rooms, I can help you.
I got you. Just know, American people, we're good. We really don't want war with you guys. Do not want war.
Mom, it's not in my business. Sorry.
Okay.
I'm not a politician. I'm a receptionist.
I got
you. I'm repeating it again. If you
I
have
understand.
Any question about the hotel, I can answer it.
Okay. Thank you. I'm sorry to bother you.
Welcome. Have a good night.
Okay. You too. Bye-bye. Should I try another one? I mean, I feel like there's people out there. They all speak English. Listen to how good their English is. I'm going to try one more hotel if I can find another hotel listing. Because I actually was going to play today the interview I did with Cenk Uygur. The thing is, it goes on for like 45 minutes. And so once this happened, I knew I wasn't going to have time to talk to anybody else, to do a full thing. All right, I've got one more phone number that we'll try calling. It, just because we can. Why not? Let's give it a shot. All right. Calling Iran again. And this number is, now that I figured out how to find the phone numbers, 888-220-2018. We'll give it one more shot. And if this doesn't work, well, then I say at least we tried. We're trying to broker peace between the United States and Iran. Because I don't know about, well, I do know about you. You don't want war either. Donald Trump has no fucking right to do this. He didn't consult Congress. In fact, I have... Hi, do you speak English?
Yes, madam, I speak English.
Hi, my name is Nicole. I'm calling from the United States. Just as a person, person to person, I want to reach out to someone in Tehran to tell you that we do not want to fight with you guys, that we have a madman as president who's doing things that does not have the approval of most of the American people. So I want to know if you guys, regular Iranians, really just hate us in America, or you realize that we're human beings too, and most of us don't like Donald Trump and don't like what he's doing.
Of course, lady, we know about that, but we as a nation, we don't war, we just love peace. We do love peace, just know that, but this is a game with, the politicians, not with the people.
Right. No, it's terrible. And we're trying to get Donald Trump out of office. You know, he's been impeached. He should not be. And the reason I think he's doing these crazy things is because he knows he's being impeached. We want to get him out of office. I'm so sorry. The general that we killed, Soleimani, is this somebody that you respect, somebody that you have affection for?
No. I don't know what to tell you about the killing or killing the our general. But may I ask you a question? Can you tell me again everything that you told me? Because I want to record it and send to my friends.
Oh, absolutely. My name is Nicole, and I do a radio show on the internet, and I wanted to reach out to somebody in Iran as a human being to human being to tell you that what our government is doing is not in our name. We do not agree with this. Most of us are freaked out about what's going on, and I wanted to reach out to just another human being in Tehran to tell you we don't want war with you. We want peace. We have crazy people running the government, and it's not okay. We're trying to get this guy out of office. So I called a hotel because that's where I figured I'd find somebody who can speak English, and I'm glad you did. And so I'm so thankful that you're talking to me. So that's what this is about. I'm actually doing a radio show. I didn't identify you, so there's no way anyone could tell who I'm talking to. But thank you for talking to me. How do you guys feel about the United States? All we hear, the media tells us that people in Iran chant death to America. Is that how most of you guys feel?
No, it's not. I don't feel that. I don't want war. I don't want death to America and the great nation of America. But just know that as an Iranian, I'm sending you this message. We do love peace. We are running from war, any war, small, big, any war. And we are sad about this terror attack from the United States. But we do love the America, United States nation. And don't forget that. Okay.
And I want you to know that most of us do not go along with Donald Trump. We have a weird system here in elections that lets the guy who got fewer votes win because it's all messed up. We want him out of office. He's already been impeached because he's a bad, bad guy. He's a bad man. And I want to reach out to say Donald Trump does not speak for me. And his actions, we are livid. We're freaked out that he did this. And we don't want war. We want peace. That's why I wanted to reach out human being to human being. And I'm so glad you picked up the phone. It's very
Thank
nice
you
to meet
much.
You. I
Thank
wish
you.
We would meet under different circumstances. What can we do to keep from going to war? Do you have any thoughts other than kicking Donald Trump out of office?
I'm not sure about that because I don't know much from politics. I just,
right.
I hope and I beg for, you know, to be each side, you know, both sides, I mean, the United States and Iran, to be calmed down and not to do any, you know, violence attack to from each other. But we're waiting, and we hope peace. We hope to both sides to calm down.
Yes, I hope. I hope so too.
Tell you this.
Now, what about Hassani, the president there, and the Ayatollah have been saying that they're gonna, you know, take retribution on the United States.
Revenge. Yes. I'm not sure, but I hope that they don't take revenge because it's. Makes the circumstances and a little bit difficult and you know, complicated, but we cannot predict absolutely what is going on in future in few days or in few hours. But we have to be calm down and be smart.
Absolutely. The average person over there, do they feel like you, or are there factions that does believe death to America, but other factions that want a more democratic way of life there?
No, this is a small, you know, population that have this, you know, opinion. But I can tell you that most of Iranian people, more than 95%, 98% of Iranian people do not believe that we should get in the war together. Mm. But death to America is, you know, really stupid sentence.
Yeah.
We do not use this in our dialogue every day. But I never use this, even in school, even in all, you know, all days of my life. Just know that.
Okay. Well, would you like to see have elections over there and have a more secular government rather than the rule of the Ayatollah?
I cannot predict. I don't know what to say. Maybe. Mm. I don't know what to say.
I gotcha. And I know I understand your, you know, hesitancy to speak. I know that there's a chilling effect over there.
Thank you
so much for talking to me. Just know that all Americans are not evil, and many of us just want to be friends.
Okay. We know that.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Happy
really
New Year.
I appreciate your time for talking with me and calling to me.
And I really appreciate you talking to me. Thank you so much. And best wishes for a happy New Year, a peaceful New Year.
Of course. Happy New Year, lady. Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good time.
You
Bye-bye.
Too. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. All right. Well, it took a few tries. It took a lot of, missteps on my part. But wow, that's what I wanted to hear. See, and he said 95, 98% of the people feel the way I do. I honestly believe that if real people would just talk to one another and get the assholes like Donald Trump and John Bolton and Mike Pompeo out of the way. And I'm sorry, you know what? Even Hillary Clinton, because someone in the YouTube chat room just said, if Hillary had won, Iran would be glass by now. I don't think we would have let her. But then again, as you can see with Donald Trump, we have no choice. We have no choice. I've had a frustrating day. At the end of a frustrating week dealing with technology, I must have done something horrible in a previous life to technology, the way that computers don't work with me. And I'll tell you one last story because I've got time to fill. I've got to make this show go for an hour. Thank you, Patricia Unruh, for the donation in the YouTube chat. I appreciate it. I actually saw a job listing. I'm not actively looking for a job, but, you know, I've been in radio since 1979, since college. And, there just are no jobs. My industry has been destroyed, as have so many, thanks to technology, thanks to consolidation, the Telecommunications Act of 1996, signed by Bill Clinton, which allowed one company to own 8 or 9 radio stations in a market where it used to just be 1 AM, 1 FM, 1 TV. And so jobs were consolidated. So I saw a listing on a site for a job, a radio job here in South Florida with one of the big radio companies, because after all that's left. And this radio company owns 8 radio stations in Miami, right? And they're looking for a promotions director. Well, I've done that job. I can do that job with my hand tied behind my back. It used to be one promotion director per radio station. This job is one promotions director to oversee all 8 radio stations, but working with the marketing director. So it's not the head of the department, right? But the marketing director, I happen to know because we worked together in Los Angeles. So I saw this job listing last night and I applied for the job and I sent a note to this guy who I used to work with, who's the marketing director, saying, "Hey, I'm here. I'd be perfect for this gig. Let's talk." And he sent me a lovely note back. And he's like, "I'm almost embarrassed to tell you that, first of all, they moved way down to Miami from where the facility used to be. So it would be a long trek each day. But, you know, hey, I'd be willing to commute if it was right." He said, "The job only pays $35,000 a year." This is Miami, which I believe is like number 11 market in the country. Number 11 market in the country. One job doing promotions for 8 radio stations, and they're paying $35,000 a year. It's criminal. It's depressing. It's sad. And I don't know how this industry survives, first of all. I don't know who they're going to get other than maybe somebody who just got out of college and doesn't know, you know, what they're doing. But here I am, someone with experience, and I could have been the perfect person to step into that gig. $35,000 a year? This is what we've come to. And Tom Steyer is spending over $100 million on this ridiculous presidential campaign. Michael Bloomberg is going to spend more than that when they could do so much good with that money. All right, I'm done ranting. I just had to share that with you because it's just another piece of the frustration puzzle that hit me today. Yeah, isn't life grand? And now I get to try to edit this together and make it an hour for Progressive Voices. Not that it'll air, because Progressive Voices has been hit by this crypto virus and they're working on it, but my shows haven't been running there. And What's News that I did hasn't been updated. Oh, I'll end with What's News. And then I'm doing the broadcast for tonight. And then it's the weekend. Welcome to 2020, everyone. All right. I'll sign off with What's News. You already heard some of it, but hey, what the hell? We'll hear it again. And I will see you back here on Tuesday with Gotta Laugh, hopefully without the audio dropping out in the middle of the show, where I have to reboot the computer again. Keep on plugging. That's all I can say. It's 2020. We'll keep on plugging. Thanks for listening, everyone. Sorry for all the technical problems. I hope you enjoyed that call to Tehran as much as I did. At least I got that one little bright spot from today. Have a great weekend, everyone. I'll see you next week. Until then.